Good morning. Hi everyone. So the most requested topic was how do I stop overeating or binge eating during this lockdown? So the first thing that I would say is, just like we had a routine when we were working or when we are going out and working, we still need to have the same kind of a routine when we are working from home as well. Okay, so what do we do? We first eat at the same time. If we had breakfast at 8, we still eat at 8. If we had lunch at 1, we still eat at 1. If our snacking was at 11 and 3 or 11 and 4, then we still do the same. And dinner 3 hours before we sleep. Okay, and have a sleep routine as well. So you wake up and sleep at the same time every day. You don't end up waking up, be awake for very long time in the night and sleep at the same time. The next thing that you can do is connect with your colleagues, friends, family if they're away from you. On an everyday basis, don't message or text them. Instead, do a video call or talk to them over a call, because that'll help you not feeling disconnected from them, right? That is one of the major reasons that we are all feeling stressed out, because we would go out and see people on an everyday basis. Humans are social beings and we need to see people every day, right? And seeing people will really help us. So socializing, we have a lot of options now, so I think we can still be in touch without actually being present, physically being present. The next thing is do some sort of an exercise every day. There are lots and lots of home workout videos available. You can do yoga, you can do aerobics, you can do spot walking, you can just dance to your favorite tune, or you could do Pilates, or you could do Tabata. There are so many things available. So you can just go through any of the YouTube videos and start doing whatever you feel like you would want to try. The next thing that you can do is pick up a new skill or a hobby that you always wanted to do but did not have the time to do it, right? And now that your commuting time is saved, I think it's the right time to invest that timings into something that you want to learn as a new skill. It could be, say, something that you wanted to read or learn, or that can improve your skill set at for your career, or it could be something that can change your life altogether, right? It can be anything. So invest your time wisely and learn something. The next thing that I would say would be drinking water or fluids more regularly. Now fluids include the water, definitely, although beverages that we drink, but choose wisely. You can make a nut, different kinds of nuts. You can roast and powder them and use it as a shake. You can have an energy bar, put all the nuts along with dates and jaggery and make it like a chicky, a dry fruit chicky, and you can have that as a snacking option. Hydration, again, coming back to hydration, I would say drink water every 1-1.5 hours, because that'll improve your digestion, your metabolism, and also reduce your stress related hunger pangs. Your water will actually fill you. So first drink a glass of water, check if you're really hungry for some food. That way you would reduce on your binge eating. The final thing that I would say is write 3 things that you're really grateful for on an everyday basis, because this is the time that you can reflect and think for the things that you're really grateful for. We always want, keep wanting a lot of things in life. We always have a big want list, but at least now it's the time that we write that the things that we are really, really grateful for. It could be very simple, or it could be somebody whom you could speak to and feel relieved. That you could be grateful for that, for having a friend or a family like that. You could be grateful for somebody helping you with the household chores. It could be your children, your spouse, your a family, anybody, right? And there, if you keep listing them down, I think at the end of the lockdown, you'll have many things that you can be grateful for. So try doing these things, and do let me know as to what are the things that worked for you and what are the things that did not work for you. Maybe then we can come up with some more new ideas, right? And since this is all new for all of us, and life in itself is uncertain, and we have to be well prepared for the uncertainties in life, so it's time that you start meditating at least 15 minutes a day. Do breathing exercises 15 to 20 minutes a day. These things will really help you in the long run, right? And build your immunity as well. So finally, thank you so much for bringing up such wonderful topics. So tomorrow I'll come up with the next popular topic and speak on that. All the best, and do let me know what you did and what you didn't do, how you felt about it. And bye bye, see you for now.